Okay, this is a assessment of a pinion topbar hive. I started from a swarm, probably about a 2-pound swarm in April, now September. Honey flow has pretty much stopped. Looks, trying to determine if they've got enough honey in their condition. I fed this hive beetles. I fed this hive quite a bit, probably about 2 gallons of syrup, but they didn't really eat much. The follower board is here. Now, they've gone ahead and filled up this hive all the way up to here. And in there, I have a feeder, a Boardman feeder I put inside the hive for feeding purposes. I think I'll take it out now. We know they might actually make a little more honey. Quite a few hive beetles in this hive. Not too bad. This has got a little honey in it. A little attachment to the walls. Not too bad though. This will be the first time I've taken this apart in several months, so normally this won't be so much attachment in the walls here. It's been a while since this hive has been apart, beyond the first couple frames. This was begun with a starter strip on the top, and it worked pretty well. The groove, there's a groove top bar there, and in that groove was a starter strip. Like they probably made enough for winter time. Hopefully I won't have to do this again. They've done quite a bit of attaching here though. More honey. There's a little brood. Much all honey with the brood in the bottom as usual. pick one more. It looks like they're going to be all right for the winter. Take a close look at this one.
Pretty typical. Not a very good brood pattern, but I think it's probably all right, what there is of it. Not too bad. Yep, may have enough honey to make it through the winter, probably.
Don't seem to do as well, in my opinion, as a Langstroth in this area, but they certainly are cheap. This hive took about 4 hours to build from start to finish. It didn't really cost that much to do. You could pretty much do it with scrap lumber if you looked around. Yep, same thing there. Brood, a little bit of brood, honey. Less honey, quite a bit of brood. These are easier to remove because I've removed them before earlier in the year. Once you remove them and cut them loose, you normally don't attach them back as strongly. The first time you take them out though, they're pretty well locked in. You have to get out the knife or use your hive tool. Okay, here we're getting back to more honey again. It looks like the front one is primarily pretty much it. Not a bad hive, really. I think they'll make it.